Crassus Clapeyron equation, also known as first latent heat equation. Clausius and Clapeyron, both are scientists, deduced an equation connecting latent heat and the rate of change of pressure with temperature. The equation already is equation known as Clausius-Clapeyron equation or first latent heat equation. The equation gives information on the variation of boiling and melting points of substances with pressure. This is an application of the second law of thermodynamics and the equation for efficiency of reversible Carnot engine. The idea is to run a Carnot engine between temperatures T and T minus dT for a two-phase medium and to let it undergo a change in phase. Change in phase means it's changing from solid to liquid, liquid to gas, or there is a change of phase. We can then derive the important equation, Clausius-Clapeyron equation, which gives the slope of the vapor pressure curve. We could then measure the vapor pressure curve for various substances and compare the measured slope of the Clausius-Clapeyron equation. Consider for deriving the Clausius-Clapeyron equation, we just consider an infinitesimal Carnot cycle ABCD. Heat is absorbed between the states A and B. To vaporize an arbitrary amount of mass m, the amount of heat Q equal to m into latent heat. Here it is represented by HFG, that is Q equal to ML, capital L, or m into HFG, must be supplied to the system. So, to change the phase or vaporize an amount of mass m, the amount of heat is required is Q equal to m into L or m into HFG. From the first and second laws of thermodynamics, the efficiency of a Carnot cycle is written as efficiency equal to W by Q equal to Q minus QR by Q or equal to T minus TR by T. That is T1 minus T2 by T1. Hence, for the infinitesimal cycle, consider we have considered the temperature changing from T to T minus dT. So dW by dQ, the efficiency dW by dQ equal to T minus dT by T, that is equal to dT cancelled, so minus plus dT by T. The work along BC and DA is adiabatic. Okay. Nearly cancel each, such that the network is the difference between the work along AB and CD. And dW can be viewed as the area enclosed by the rectangle ABCD. Therefore, dW equal to m into VG minus VF into DP. Substituting this relation in this equation, we can write m into VG minus VF DP by m into HFG or m into L. MM cancel, then we can write this is v1 minus v2. Okay, we can also write like that, or v2 minus v1. Then mm cancel, then we will get the Clausius-Clapeyron equation, that is dp by dt equal to, by rearranging this statement, we can write dp by dt equal to hfg. Hfg is 13L divided by t into v2 minus v1. This is v1, this is v2. So we can write v2 minus v1. So Clausius-Clapeyron equation is dp by dt equal to L by t into v2 minus v1, or dp by dt equal to hfg by t into vg minus vf. From this expression, from this plot, this is also known as first latent heat equation. നമുക്ക് അങ്ങനെയും question വരാം. ഫസ്റ്റ് ലാറ്റന്റ് ഹീറ്റ് ഇക്വേഷൻ ഏതാണെന്ന് ചോദിച്ചിട്ട് വരാം. ക്ലാസിയസ് ക്ലാപ്പറോൺ ഇക്വേഷന്റെ ഡെറിവേഷൻ ആയിട്ടും ചോദിക്കാം. ഈ ഡെറിവേഷൻ വളരെ എളുപ്പമാണ് അല്ലേ. നമുക്കിനി അതിൻ്റെ ആപ്ലിക്കേഷൻസ് നോക്കാം. ആപ്ലിക്കേഷൻസ് ഓഫ് ക്ലോസസ് ക്ലാപ്പറോൺ ഇക്വേഷൻ. ഫസ്റ്റ്, എഫക്ട് ഓഫ് പ്രഷർ ഓൺ ബോയിലിംഗ് പോയിന്റ് ഓഫ് ലിക്വിഡ് വെൻ ദേർസ് എ ഫേസ് ചേഞ്ച്, റൈറ്റ്? When a liquid is converted into gaseous state, and there is a phase change from liquid to gas, the volume V2 of the gas is always greater than the corresponding volume V1 of the liquid. Thus, V2 minus V1 is positive. Since L and T are positive, the value dP by dt, dP by dt is also positive. This is positive, this is positive. Then dp by dt is also positive. This means that the boiling point of every liquid rises with the increase in pressure. In the case of water, the increase of one atmospheric pressure, that is change of pressure with the changing time, changing temperature. In the case of water, the increase of one atmospheric pressure, 76 centimeter of mercury, increases the boiling point by 27.92 degrees Celsius. Similarly, the decrease of one atmospheric pressure decreases the boiling point by 27.92 degrees Celsius. This is best explained by the pressure cooker. In the pressure cooker, the liquid boils at higher temperature. ഇതൊരു ജനറൽ ക്വസ്റ്റൻ ആയിട്ട് വേണമെങ്കിൽ ചോദിക്കാം, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഷോർട്ട് ആൻസർ ഒക്കെ ചോദിക്കാം. ഇൻ ദ പ്രഷർ കുക്കേഴ്സ് ദ ലിക്വിഡ് ബോയിൽസ് അറ്റ് ഹയർ ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ബിക്കോസ് ദ പ്രഷർ ഇൻസൈഡ് ഈസ് മോർ ദാൻ ദ അറ്റ്മോസ്ഫിയറിക് പ്രഷർ. ആൻഡ് സിമിലർലി ഇൻ ദി ഹൈ ആൾട്ടിറ്റ്യൂഡ്സ് ദ അറ്റ്മോസ്ഫിയറിക് പ്രഷർ ഈസ് ലോവർ, ദസ് വാട്ടർ ബോയിൽസ് അറ്റ് ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ലെസ് ദാൻ 100 ഡിഗ്രി സെൽഷ്യസ്. At higher pressure, require more the boiling point shift to higher point. At lower pressure, the boiling point decreases. Then second application is the effect of change of pressure on the melting points. When a solid is converted into liquid, there is a change in volume. It means volume increases when solid is changed into liquid. For substances like wax and sulfur, V2 minus V1 is positive, that is wax and sulfur expand on melting. In such cases, dP by dT is positive. That is, the rate of change of pressure with respect to temperature is positive. Thus, the melting point of the substance will increase with increase in pressure and vice versa. This already melting point of the substance will increase with increase in pressure and vice versa. For substances like ice and bismuth, which contract on melting, V2 minus V1 is negative. In this case, dP by dT is negative. That is, melting point is lowered with increase in pressure. Melting point is lowered with increase in pressure. Hence, ice will melt at temperature lower than 0 degree centigrade at pressure higher than the normal pressure. Ice melts at 0 degree Celsius only at a pressure of 76 centimeter of mercury. For an increase of 1 atmospheric pressure, the depression of freezing point for ice is minus 0.00774 degrees Celsius. The equation for the variation of the latent heat with temperature is known as second latent heat equation or Clausius latent heat equation. The second latent heat equation is C2 minus C1 equal to dL by dT minus L by T, where C1, C2 are the specific heat of the substance used in Carnot engine at liquid phase in contact with saturated vapor and at vapor phase in contact with saturated vapor respectively. Then calculation of latent heat. The calculation of latent heat of vaporization of water at 100 degree Celsius is possible by assuming the values of other quantities in Clausius Clapeyron equation. Similarly, we can obtain the internal and external latent heats. The internal latent heat is used for changing the internal energy of the liquid, and external latent heat is for doing external work during change of volume against external pressure. The latent heat of vaporization of liquid is the sum of the two latent heats. Latent heat of vaporization of liquid is L is equal to Li internal and L plus E Le is external, latent heat of external. Then Li equal to L minus Le, Le is equal to P into dV, V2 minus V1. And we already know that from the Clausius Clapeyron equation, dP by dT equal to L by T into V2 minus V1. By rearranging, we can write L equal to T into V2 minus V1 into dP by dT from Clausius Clapeyron equation. Hence, Li, then substitute these terms in this equation. And substitute this also here. So Li equal to T into V2 minus V1 dP by dT minus P into V2 minus V1. Then rearranging, taking into a common bracket. So Li equal to T into V2 minus V1 into dP by dT minus P by T. Substituting the values of T, V2 minus V1, dP by dT and P by dT, we can have the values of Li, and we can also find the latent L. Okay. Thank you.